Dear students, welcome all of you. So in today we are going to see some high yield 10 MCQs on the topic hemoglobinopathies. First of all, tell me, can you all hear me? Am I audible, guys? Please tell me. Are you able to hear me? Good evening, Manas Tripathi. Good to see you. Okay, so good. Thanks, Manas, for telling that I am audible. Okay, so we can begin the class. First of all, let me tell about my upcoming plus course in the An Academy platform. So there is this new course, revision course on biochemistry for FMGE December 2020. So this course will go from September 4 to October 31. But this is, even though this is FMGE, will be useful for NEET PG and anyone who is preparing for something biochemistry, right? So look at this. So this, the peculiarity about this course is that the course duration is 34 hours. So it is going to be an exclusive and complete course. So this will be a complete course of biochemistry. So this starts on September 4. In September 4, I'll discuss bioenergetics. So what is bioenergetics? So here we will study the role of ATP, biological oxidation, electron transport chain, TCA cycle, everything. So there are 4 hours for this topic. Then we have 4 hours for enzymology, then 6 hours for chemistry of carbohydrates and metabolism. Then in the month of October, you have 6 hours for lipid metabolism, 6 hours for amino acid, 6 hours for molecular biology, and finally there is some 2 hours for clinical biochemistry. Okay, so this 34 hours course is going to be really useful for all of you. So whoever wants to subscribe for An Academy Plus subscription, please take it now. So this is the right time. Use Dr. Karthi as the coupon code. You will get 10% instant discount. Okay, so having said this, let's start MCQs. So as I have already told you, the topics will be on hemoglobinopathies. Answer this: which of the following is a quantitative hemoglobinopathy? So which is a quantitative hemoglobinopathy? Tell me, guys. So among the following: HBC disease, HBH disease, sickle cell anemia, and with hemoglobinemia. So which one is a quantitative hemoglobinopathy? Answer. Okay, so Manas was asking, what is FMG? FMG is Foreign Medical Graduate Entrance Examination. So that is FMG. Okay, Manas? Okay, so let's see the answers. Shiv Patel is saying answer is A. Supriya is saying D. Suresh is saying C. Deepan is saying T. Okay. Seshagopalan is saying D. Hi, Seshagopalan. Welcome. So first of all, you have to know the difference between quantitative and qualitative. So it seems the first question itself is a very good question. So there are two types of hemoglobinopathies: quantitative, qualitative, right? Hi Dasarath. So Dasarath is also saying answer is B. Let's see. So qualitative means, look at this, in HBC disease, hi Bupinder. So in beta chain, sixth position, glutamic acid will be replaced by lysine. So in sickle cell disease anemia, that is HBS, same beta, in sixth position, glutamic acid will be replaced by valine. Right. So in methemoglobinemia, so the ferrous iron of heme is converted into ferric iron. Clear? So what is common here among these? Among these, the common is, hi Prabha Venkat. So look at this, A, C, D. So the common is the quality is affected. Clear? The quantity of hemoglobin is common, normal only. See, in the hemoglobin protein there is change. Okay, so that is why. So A, C, D, these are all qualitative hemoglobinopathies. What is HbH? What is HbH? Tell me, guys. What is HbH? So there is something called Hb bots also. There is something called HbH also. So what is the difference between HbH and Hb bots? Tell me. What is the difference? Hb bots is what? HbH is what? Tell me. What is Hb bots? That's what my question. So Hb bots and HbH both are homotetramers. So these are homotetramers. Right? So Shaiv Patel gave the correct answer. Hb bots is gamma 4. And HbH is kind of beta 4. Clear? So this is gamma 4 Hb bots and this is beta 4. Right? Any doubt in this? So these are all this. So these that means HbH is like, so as Seshagopalan correctly pointed out, so that is what? Thalassemia, alpha thalassemia, right? HbH you see in alpha thalassemia. Okay, so it is a thalassemia. What is the meaning of thalassa? Thalassa means sea, ocean. Okay, so this thalassemia and all, they are found in the mainly in the coastal region. Okay, so that is why thalassemia name came. So HbH, that is thalassemia, is a quantitative. Okay, so that's correct only. So this is the correct answer. Next one. Which of the following is the most common clinical manifestation of sickle cell disease? In sickle cell disease, there are a lot of manifestation. Which one is the most common one? Tell me. Is this aplastic crisis or splenic sequestration, vaso-occlusive crisis or acute chest syndrome? Yogita Sharma, good evening. How are you doing? So excellent, Seshagopalan. So Seshagopalan is saying that vaso-occlusive crisis is the most common clinical manifestation. Good. So Sindhu Vijay, Supriya, Manas, Shavi Patel. Good. So you all gave the correct answer. So vaso-occlusive crisis is the correct answer. Okay. So these sickle cells, no, no, Bubinder Roy. It is the vaso-occlusive crisis, not aplastic crisis. Aplastic crises are often preceded by which of the following? Answer this. So now we are discussing about this aplastic crisis. Is it parvovirus B19 or cold weather, emotional stress, acidosis? So which one? Tell me. Sindhu Vijay, nice. Soumyadeep, Sanyasi, nice. So cold weather, emotional stress. Shakila Hamad, Supriya Singh, Sesoko Balan, Dinesh Kumar, nice. So all of you are giving correct answers. So all these are going to cause Deepan, excellent. So all these are going to cause vaso-occlusive crisis. In cold weather, it will cause vasoconstriction, right? Emotional stress, acidosis. They are all going to cause vaso-occlusive crisis, not the aplastics. So aplastic crisis is going to be caused by parvovirus. So it is a viral infection. Okay. So in infants, this causes, right? So in infants also, certain infants also, parvovirus cause aplastic anemia. Good. So all of you answered this question nicely. Next one. All of the following are true about methemoglobinemia except in methemoglobinemia, ferrous iron is oxidized to ferric iron, either congenital or acquired, leads to hemolysis, oxygen binding capacity is lost. So which one is the correct answer? Hi Shireen, so I think you may be finding it difficult to understand the Indian accent, so we cannot help it. Answer? Okay, so you are all saying the answer is C. What about the options? Option A, ferrous iron is oxidized to ferric. So hemoglobin is usually oxygenated, but it is not oxidized, right? So ferrous is converted into ferric. So that is why the oxygen binding capacity is lost. So methemoglobin cannot bind to oxygen. Yeah, it can be either congenital or acquired. Acquired, any oxidizing agent. So any drugs which causes oxidation. Okay. Option D is correct. Oxygen binding capacity is lost. So it leads to hemolysis is a wrong answer. So it is the oxygen binding capacity that is lost. Hemolysis is not going to happen. When will hemolysis happen? In which condition? Conditions like G6PD deficiency and all. So there only you will have hemolysis. Not in this condition. Right? In this condition, you won't have hemolysis. Remember. Next one. A person who is heterozygous for sickle anemia has increased risk for increased resistance for which of the following? Easiest question for today. Answer this. So based on this, there are a lot of things. So many conditions they give protection against certain diseases like cystic fibrosis gives protection against cholera. So it is said that cystic fibrosis gives protection against cholera. So that is why in Caucasian population cystic fibrosis is common, right? So this is why, even though this is a mutation, so why this mutation is selected? This is natural selection. Even though this condition causes some harm, this condition is selected because this condition like heterozygous sickle cell mutation, it gives selective advantage, right? So it gives selective advantage. So here it will be falciparum malaria. So falciparum malaria will cause cerebral malaria. So that is a severe form of malaria, and sickle cell trait gives protection against this. Good. Let's move ahead. So hereafter the questions will be lengthier, so I will give enough time for you to read the question. Which of the following would not benefit a patient with beta thalassemia? So let's see who all gave correct answer in the previous question. Pankaj Roy, Sindhu Vijay, Manas Tripathi, Keshagopalan, Shaiv Patel, Deepan Twins, Yogita, Supriya. Nice. Somdeep Sanyasi, you all gave correct answer. Okay. Manas Tripathi, it is not like that no case of malaria in South Africa. So heterozygous state, so it's not that everyone will be having sickle cell trait, right? So those who are having sickle cell trait, they will get protection against falciparum malaria. So like that G6PD deficiency, that also gives protection against malaria, okay, but the different parasite form. Okay, so that's sub-Saharan Africa and all, this endemic for malaria, right? So that is why in that area these mutations are all selected. G6PD you will find in sub-Saharan Africa. G6PD deficiency will be common in sub-Saharan Africa. Clear? So let's see in this question how people are saying. So increasing alpha globin production, so everyone is saying option C. Some people are saying D also, some people are saying E also. Okay, so in beta thalassemia major, what's going to happen? So in beta thalassemia major, beta chains won't be produced, so that is beta thalassemia. Beta chains will be decreased. So there will be imbalance in the alpha chain. So alpha chain will be more, right? Relatively in the disease condition. And this causes ineffective erythropoiesis. Hi Nitish Kumar, welcome. So this causes ineffective erythropoiesis. So this ineffective erythropoiesis is going to lead to hemolysis. So this hemolysis now is going to increases the iron overload. So that is why in this condition we give iron chelation, and because of anemia you give transfusion, but you have to give iron chelation also. So this is the correct answer. In beta thalassemia, beta chains are less, so you can increase the beta globin production. So nowadays there are a lot of gene therapies on trial. So using CRISPR-Cas9 system or induced pluripotent stem cells, so all these things. So they are trying for increasing the beta globin in this condition. Okay, so here the beta globins are the one which is defective. Why are you increasing alpha globin? Clear? So what is the point of increasing the alpha globin? Already there is imbalance in the alpha chain, so there is no point of increasing alpha globin. Clear? So you can actually decrease the alpha globin, that is correct. And increasing fetal hemoglobin also correct. Why? So what is fetal hemoglobin? Alpha 2 gamma 2. So in beta thalassemia, beta chains are not there, we can have alpha 2 gamma 2. Clear, Nitish Kumar? So increasing fetal hemoglobin production is fine. Compared to option C, you should not increase alpha globin production. So that is the wrong option. So compared to that, this is fine. Okay, so with this let's move to the next question. This is also another interesting question. And alpha thalassemia silent carrier man. So why we are saying silent carrier? Look at the genotype, alpha alpha alpha. So three alpha chain producing alleles are normal, So there is just one allele which is absent. So that is why this is like silent. So for beta, you will have like only two allele, right? Beta, beta. So okay, Tipan, but beta, there will be already fetal hemoglobin will be somewhat high. That's you are correct only. But we have to choose the best option. So the best answer is option C in that question. Okay, Tipan. Okay, so this is silent, right? Out of the four alleles, three are present, so it is silent. So yeah, after the end of the class, you can ask your doubts, Nitish. So let me complete the scheduled questions. So let me complete the 10 MCQs. Then you can ask your doubts. Okay, Nitish. Next comes mates with alpha thalassemia trait. So here it is a trait because it's not disease because two alleles are there. So which of the following is not a possible genotype of their offspring? Tell me, guys, give the correct answer. So alpha. So here you can draw like this, alpha minus. So draw like this. So if these two, what will you get? Okay, so then what will you get? What will you get? So it's simple. So how many are possible? So four are possible, right? So look at this. So alpha dash and this one dash. So this is also possible, right? So A is possible. So this one alpha. So let me go and show here alpha. So the first, so this is also possible. Then come, so this alpha and this one, this is also possible. Look at the D. So alpha, this one. So this and this, so this is also possible. But you see here, so in this location you have only this alpha dash. So only one, there is one alpha dash. So obviously option E is not possible. Clear? Any doubts? It's a very simple logic based question. Let's see how many of you answered it correctly. Yogita Sharma, Sindhu Vijay, Samyudip Sanyasi, Pankaj Roy. Yes. So excellent, guys. So this is very, very simple question. So in sometimes, like in the exams, they can ask very simple logic based question. Is this clear? If there is any doubt, ask me. Simple question, right? Good. Now again, another logic based question. Let me go to that. All of the following are examples of mutations which have been observed on a beta thalassemia allele except. So Yogita, you have four alleles, right? So that is why, so the manifestations may be same. Okay, but these are different, right? So this genotype, so that is one see, for anything we have maternal and paternal, right? So that is why we write alpha dash and then alpha dash. Clear? So what Yogita Sharma is asking is, so she is asking alpha dash. Alpha, I think that's what she is asking. But look at this, so this is from maternal or paternal, something like this. So this can be maternal and paternal. So these are obviously different. Clear, Yogita? So now answer this question, guys. Don't worry, the question is lengthy, but it is very simple question. I will explain you. Once I explain, you will find that, oh, this question is very easy. Answer this easy question. So which mutation is not possible in beta thalassemia? Otherwise, which is not going to cause beta thalassemia? So the correct way of putting the question is, which is not a pathogenic mutation in beta thalassemia? Shaktidasan, welcome. Long time no see. How are you, Shaktidasan? Sindhu Vijay, good, nice. Sindhu Vijay and Shaktidasan are saying option E. Others wait. Others, if you don't know, it's not an issue. I am going to explain. So if you know what is a mutation in HBS, so in sickle cell anemia, what is a mutation? In sickle cell anemia, the mutation is beta 6 glutamate 2 valine. So even if you don't know what are A, B, C, D, it's not an issue. Okay. Excellent, Prabha Venkat, excellent, Deepan. Manas, now can you understand this? So look at the option E. So it is a missense mutation in codon 6. So codon 6 means it's going to code for protein. So in the codon 6 of beta globin gene, valine gets substituted in place of glutamic acid. So glutamic acid is a polar amino acid, negatively charged, right? So it's a polar amino acid. Valine is a non-polar amino acid. So because of this, in the surface of hemoglobin, there is formation of a sticky patch. Okay, in the deoxyhemoglobin, you have sticky patch receptor also. So there is sticky patch and sticky patch receptor interaction happening, leading to ultimately polymerization and precipitation of hemoglobin inside the RBC. Clear, guys? In this question, if you know that the mutation in sickle cell hemoglobin is this one, beta 6 glutamate 2 valine, so obviously that is the pathogenic mutation of sickle cell disease, not for beta thalassemia. So let's look into other thing. So look at this. What is beta thalassemia? It is a quantitative defect, right? Quantitative. So this one is, see, qualitative. So this is qualitative. Okay. So this is, so Tipan is saying that valine is the villain in sickle cell anemia. Good, Tipan. So good way for you to remember. The mutation creating a new splice site. So many splicing mutation will lead to quantity. The quantity of the beta globin protein will be altered, right? Initiator ATG, ATG. Because so in the DNA it is ATG. Here it will be AUG. Clear? So this is the ATG is the coding strand. So we always give the coding strand sequence. So when you write the RNA, so you will write AUG. Okay. So polyadenylation signal. So polyadenylation, if there is mutation, the length of the messenger RNA will be obviously affected. So the length of the protein will also be affected. So splice site mutation. So any splice site mutation is going to cause thalassemia. Okay, simple question. Good. Answer this. Which would not be an effective way to diagnose sickle cell anemia? So polymerase chain reaction of exon 1 of beta globin gene followed by ASO. So this is antisense oligonucleotide hybridization with all these things. So don't go very deep, just look into all the options, then you will find out the wrong option. That's why I put this question. Even if you don't know what is restriction digestion and all, not an issue. Just look carefully all the option. You will surely find out which is the wrong option. There is one option which is obviously wrong. Let's see. Okay, so Prabha Venkat and Karthik, you are thinking that option E is the answer. Let's see what others are saying. I think, okay, so we have some questions. Oh, we have two more questions. Supriya is saying D. Shavi Patel is saying C. So Priya, in Harper, have you seen in Harper they have given this example only for sickle cell anemia diagnosis? They have obviously given this. So this is one. So look at this, guys. So Neeraja Kundeti, welcome Neeraja, good to see you. So hemoglobin is not enzyme. Okay. Ceruloplasmin is an enzyme. Ceruloplasmin is an enzyme with peroxidase activity. But hemoglobin is just a transport protein. It's not an enzyme. So how will you do enzymatic assay for hemoglobin activity? Clear. Hemoglobin is not an enzyme. Simple one, right? Even if you don't know all the other option, just by this you can easily answer. Good, 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 Manas. Clear. Let's move ahead. HBE is best described as which of the following? Look at this. Hemoglobin E. So what is HBE? What is the mutation in HBE? HBE in the 26th or 29th position. So in that position again, 26th or 29th. So there, in the same thing, so it will be like glutamic acid, okay, will be replaced by amino acid, right? Now tell me, what is the answer? So 26 only, so it was correct in the 26th position. 26th position of hemoglobin, it is same like glutamic acid is replaced by lysine. So similar to that HBC, but the position is different. So the position is 26th position, right? Okay. So let's see what you guys are saying. Prabha Venkat, he told answer is E. So Prithviraj B. So there is a lot of difference of opinion. Huh? So let me show you the answer. The answer is thalassemic hemoglobinopathy. So this hemoglobinopathy is usually associated with certain forms of thalassemia. So that is why this is known as thalassemic hemoglobinopathy. Clear? So this as such HBE is common in Southeast Asia, but not, you cannot call it as a pure thalassemia. It is not thalassemia, right? It's a qualitative defect, but it is usually associated with thalassemia. So that is why they call HBE as a thalassemic hemoglobinopathy. Clear? So that is the name. Yeah, it cannot be thalassemia. Clear? HBE as such is not thalassemia, but it is associated with mostly thalassemia. Clear? So You just Google it, you will find out. So HBE is associated with thalassemia. So that is why the answer is thalassemic hemoglobinopathy. Okay, so I have taken all these questions from certain standard resources. Okay, so this I have taken from standard books and I have verified the answers also. Good. So final questions, easiest question, so that in the final question everyone should answer. I want answer from everyone. Nitish, you can ask your doubt. Whatever doubt you have, you can answer. Sorry, you can ask, I will answer. I will try to answer. So Yogita is asking some question. If splice sites are mutated G to A of 5' splice site, will there be any difference during splicing than the, let's see, splice sites in the 5' splice sites, you will have GU, AG. Will there be any difference during splicing than the normal type 1 and type 2 splicing? G to A. So if there is G to A, so obviously there will be a difference, right? Okay. So in this question, I think everyone is going to give it the correct answer. So carboxyhemoglobin means it is your carbon monoxide and it is going to bind to ferrous iron of heme. CO2 is actually going to bind to amino acids. It's going to produce carbaminohemoglobin. Okay, so this carboxyhemoglobin, it produces cherry red color, right? So cherry red color. So most of the time in the cases, in the clinical cases and all, they ask like this. Someone was burning coal during a winter day. So in the next day, they found that these people are unconscious and died. So that is especially due to carbon monoxide. Why? Carbon monoxide is produced during incomplete combustion of fuel, incomplete combustion. So in complete combustion you will get CO2. So incomplete combustion you will get carbon monoxide. Okay, so that is why you have to give enough oxygen. So when enough oxygen is not available, so when enough oxygen is available, C. So enough oxygen, CO2, right? So enough oxygen is not available, so only one oxygen to carbon, so carbon monoxide. Okay. So anyway, these days we are not using wooden for burning no more, right? So those days we used to have. Even in our house, when we make hot water for shower and all, we used to use wood only. But these days, because of modernization, most of the people are not using this. Same time, carbon monoxide is going to inhibit complex 4 of electron transport chain. This also we have to remember, complex 4 of ETC. What are the inhibitors of complex 4 of electron transport chain? CO, CN and H2S. Okay, and some azides, and some azides. They all inhibit complex 4 of electron transport chain. Good. So guys, it was a great session because all of you were actively participating. Good, good. Good to see you. Nice. Nice, Yogita. Manas Tripathi, welcome. Good to see that you got benefited from this class also. Nice. So what will be my next month's classes? So in the Unacademy platform, I will be taking at least 4 hours of free special classes. So that will be there. So I am thinking to take certain theory classes and all. I may take translation, that is protein translation. Then thinking of either electron transport chain. Then The questions from ANAD Physio Biochem. So that is preclinical. So maybe preclinical questions I may take 1 hour. Then I may take Path Pharma Forensic for second year. Micro. So here I can take 20 MCQs, here 20 MCQs. So this will be like theory plus MCQs. This I'm just thinking. Let's see how things are turning out. I will update you guys. Okay. So with this, we are completing today's sessions. All of you have a happy weekend. Bye bye. See you. The problem with taking theory session on the YouTube, Manas Tripathi, so the An Academy wants the engaging sessions, right? Are you understanding? So in the here there will be lag also. So that is why. So there will be lag. So when I so what I what happens is here is in the YouTube streaming. So when I speak, it actually comes to you. After some 30-40 seconds. So when I ask something, it's going to take time for you to reach. But in the An Academy platform, there is no stream. It is like real time. So that is why theory classes will be best when taken on the An Academy platform. It is free also. Manas Tripathi, you should come to the An Academy special class. Okay, it is free only. It's for free for everyone. And please share these links and all with all your batchmates. So all of you, please share the links with your friends. So let everyone get benefited. Okay? Okay, guys.